garbage everywhere. Hello again, Internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. Today, I have a mixture of stuff, and in this particular episode, it's not just music. I actually have gotten some things that I found worth sharing that is not music. I have one movie and one book to show off, in addition to a bunch of CDs that I got, so I decided to throw those in and get going with this. So, let's begin here. First thing I got, Sigur Rós's album. I don't know how to pronounce this because it's Icelandic, but I will say that this is their second album, and I got this one because I have heard of this band, and I've heard very good things about this band, but I never actually listened to them. I initially wanted to get their first album because the cover looked really cool. It was like a baby's face and it was like in a black hole. It just looked awesome. But I listened to that and I wasn't entirely impressed by it, so I moved on to this album because I had heard better things about this, and I was blown away by it. This is such a fantastic record. It's gorgeous. It's so awesome. And it's funny because I had mentioned in a vlog, I think it was the Sleepy vlog, that I had seen Life Aquatic, and they actually used a song off of this album in the movie, so it was sort of a strange coincidence that I happened to get this album.
My life, the part of me that loves me, is stimulated.
My computer's possessed. Okay. Thought it was a weird coincidence that I saw the movie and had no idea that that Sigur Rós song was on it, and I just happened to buy the album shortly thereafter. Great album, worth checking out if you've never heard of this band or even haven't heard this album. Super good. CD I have here is a Burt Bacharach Greatest Hits. So I shamefully had never heard of this guy until, I think a couple months ago. My dad and I were watching a short film that was the original short film that created Napoleon Dynamite. The film used his song Alfie, and I thought, this is a cool song, I like this. And I said that out loud, and my dad was like, oh yeah, do you know who this is? And I was like, no. And he was shocked because I had never heard of Burt Bacharach. So after him lecturing me about how amazing Burt was and how he was just huge into the pop realm of things, I decided to educate myself and get a Burt album. I mostly got this album because the song Alfie is on it, but other songs like What the World Needs Now is Love, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, and I'll Never Fall in Love Again. Those are all classic songs. Well, now I know they're classic songs because I actually know who the damn guy is. It's such corny, cheesy love songs, but it's still really good. Burt, thank you for your cheesy music. Okay, I think it's time to show off one of my non-music selections. This is a book. This is a book by Daniel Johnston. This was a gift by my girlfriend on Valentine's Day, just because she knows how much I love Daniel and his music. He did this odd comic book called Space Ducks. It is full of his bizarre artwork. When he's not doing music, Daniel does all these drawings. He's been drawing since he was a kid, and he loved comic books because of the artwork. It just looks so fascinating, and I love Daniel Johnston to death, so I'm sure it'll be quite the read.
When I came around, love had lingered on my mind. She said on the telephone.
Next CD I have is a Movietone album. This band is some obscure little post-rock band that I heard of because the now former member of Flying Saucer Attack is in this band. Initially, Flying Saucer Attack was a collaboration between Dave Pierce and Rachel Brook, and then Rachel left the band just so she could focus her time on Movietone. I saw this at Amoeba, it was only $1.99, and I thought, oh yeah, this is Rachel's band, so maybe I'll dig it because she was in Flying Saucer Attack, so it'll have some experimental qualities to it. The interesting thing about this album is the songs on here were recorded in different spots. The liner notes say that two songs were recorded under a beach One in a city, one in a church, one in a warehouse, and one in a house. And that made the music really interesting, added some interesting ambient qualities to it. Natural ambient qualities even, which is super cool. Plus this was on the Drag City label, and Drag City has put out some phenomenal work. I'm excited to own this one, and I'm excited to listen to it a little bit more. Next CD I have is by a band called A Winged Victory for the Sullen. There's an ambient band I absolutely love called Stars of the Lid, and they have put out some absolutely stellar music. This band is one of the guys from Stars of the Lid, as well as a pianist, and they put out several albums, including this one. And this one actually is a soundtrack for, I believe it's a, I don't know where it's from, but it is a foreign film called Iris. I've been aware for A Winged Victory for quite some time, but I'd never actually listened to them. And this one I would always see at Amoeba whenever I'd go see if they had any Stars of the Lid stuff. I'd always find this one in the Stars of the Lid section. Finally, I thought, okay, I should listen to these guys because I love Stars of the Lid, so if these guys are similar, then this should be good. I haven't actually seen the movie. Either way, it'll be an interesting listen, and maybe I should see the movie after I listen to this, but until then, I'm gonna enjoy the hell out of this one. Speaking of movies, I have here a movie. This is Zodiac. This is a phenomenal movie. I love this movie. It's a really, really long movie, but the whole length of it I think is totally worth watching. What I like about this movie is the first half of it is the public reaction to the Zodiac killer. So we're basically presented with the killer and then the mystery and the investigation surrounding it. And then the second half of the movie focuses on Jake Gyllenhaal's character, who is a cartoonist for the newspaper that puts out the Zodiac's stuff. And he starts getting insanely obsessed with the killer, so much so that it's like destroying his marriage and it's taking up most of his life. And he is investigating and trying to figure out who the killer is. And it's even to the point where the investigation is not really that relevant anymore. So people are kind of like, yeah, whatever. But he's like so set on figuring out who it is. It's a great movie. It's got a great cast. It's got Mark Ruffalo, Jake Gyllenhaal, as I mentioned, and Robert Downey Jr. It's super great. It's like, again, I had to own this one. And considering that it was only $2.99, totally worth picking up and totally worth checking out.
Greek, Morse code, astrological signs. This guy's used them all.
I like killing people because man is the most dangerous animal of all.
How does one do that?
I like puzzles. I do them a lot.
The last album I have here is an album by Low. I've talked about Low in past videos. I think I've picked up a couple of their albums in the past couple of Amoeba and Chill episodes. Low is one of those bands that I enjoyed, but I never really got too into them. I just thought, like, yeah, they're cool, but, you know, whatever. But it wasn't until recently where I started re-listening to the album of theirs that was produced by Jeff Tweedy, the name is escaping me, and suddenly I was like, holy shit, this is such a great album. How have I not gotten into this sooner? So I was listening to the hell out of that album, and that inspired me to go look into more of their work, and I picked up this one because it seemed similar sounding to the Jeff Tweedy produced album. I think this one is like the album before or two albums before it. The other awesome part of it is the cover. It just looks gorgeous. It looks totally like something I would listen to. Plus it's on the Sub Pop label, so that's another great thing. And speaking of Wilco, I think, if I'm not mistaken, let's check the liner notes here. Nels Klein, who's Wilco's guitarist, does some work on this one, so that ties into probably how they got to know Jeff in the first place. Low is such a great band. I'm insanely in love with them. I'm like super looking forward to listening to this one, and I might end up getting more of their material because they've got a lot of CDs. But until then, I'm gonna enjoy this one.
And when you finally submit it to embarrassing cash.
Okay, internet, that does it for me. There's a lot of noise outside of my room, and I don't know what's going on, so I'm gonna go investigate. So this is Olin from What I'm Listening To, signing out. Goodbye.